Detective? Oh, he was a detective. Oh.
Prince Valium guy, right? Is that holy moly? I didn't even take the space bug for me. Nor the Levis bread.
All right, define discrimination, big tech, Apple, go. Because I choose business ethics, and let me explain something. These set of screenshots that I just took, perfectly described. You put an Aruno thing, you repinned it from 2 years ago, and I mentioned something about how we're committing crimes, and we just don't want to get caught. So because of that, we're going to change your 5G setting to SOS, first of all. We have no right to do it, but we're AT&T, we're going to do it. SOS. Then I'm going to write, fuck your shit, fuck your SOS. Then that it's going to reset, and it's going to say, okay, you're back to AT&T 5G. We're sorry. And then I'm going to restart it. And then I'm going to go back and see if I can get on the internet without having to be on the Xfinity Wi-Fi. And sometimes it's vice versa. The Xfinity Wi-Fi won't let me, and only the 5G will help. And it's stupid. And my phone is hacked, and they changed the stuff, yo. And it's like, you know how you can share screen mode if you give them permission and same with the phone? Well, I just don't ask permission. I mean, it's perfect, right? They have your fingerprint and your face scan and whatever. It's just so perfect, right? And let alone for like digital, like, see, Your Honor, look at the video. They must have done that. It looks just like them. I mean, we don't need a dystopian future with gaslighters at the helm. And we're not going to do it. And you're not quite there yet. And we're just not going to do it. So, anyway, the next set of screenshots is after the phone restarts, Mr. Musk. So then what happens is I go back and I check out the internet. Yes, I have it. I can get onto Safari. I can click around. I can get on certain websites, not Facebook, not X, but I can get on like Yahoo after taking screenshots. Excuse me, Yahoo, are you saying you won't give me permission to connect like through the 5G or something? Because, yeah, they have, like, little switch box people who just decide what apps are going to in real time. And then they, like, program it to, like, a mean algorithm designed to, if you, and it's stupid. And no one shuts them down because they don't know anything about how they could be that vain and stupid with their antisocial social club. But I assure you, it's garbage like that, for the most part, that makes them covet, like, their envy of people. They'll understand, like, yeah, we shouldn't have done Rat Race and, like, Divergent with Jeff Daniels one with the cameras. At any rate, they did do that. They don't think, but they want that, like, they want that for the future, like, verbatim, but they also sort of have it now with the, like, if you've seen Snowden, right? Anyway, that was about technology in 2008 to 2010. No, really. So now it's 15 years later from that point. At any rate, so then I established, okay, Yahoo now works. I don't know about Facebook, but I'll check out X. Nope, still not working through Safari. Go immediately to the X app. Sure enough, boop, there it is. Nope, that's still there, and they allow me to, like, go on it. And my account's still there, and it's safe and sound on X. Except if I go to my profile page, it doesn't load anything. Because define discrimination. Well, someone is still discriminating in real time in X, within X, because X works, but my page, nope, it's, we hide it every time you don't personally look at it, and then we bring it back so you can't take screenshots that maybe we're doing that. Even on the X app, let alone on the Safari version of it, which is the main copy, and then the X app is sort of like a backup copy that happens right away, and then you can sort of switch and have, but like, it's not, different, and it's not supposed to be different. It's supposed to be seamless. Mr. Musk knows this. But again, he can't place a phone call to me or an email. He can click like on several tweets, so I know he's aware of my, like, existence. Not really. I don't, like, brag about it or take screenshots and post them and, like, what you people do with, oh, my God, I'm at the I don't do that. I'm trying to get our rights back, same as Mr. Musk. He's Donatello. I agree. Like, Leonardo and him are the leaders. And then me and Raphael, the Piper, call her Raphael the Piper, right, Mr. Musk? I mean, she's very talented. But we're trapped like rats in a cage, and we can only sort of do, like, do-do-do on the camera, yo. We don't want to be a social influencer. That's you people with the brainwashing. But again, so you see these screenshots. Discrimination. They should never be alleged. It's not up to a 5G company or some asshole in a different country that we're going to shoot dead if you don't just let it go. Why do you got to touch it? if you insist before they lock you out on continuing to harass me of all people, because even out of all the Americans you could do that to, you're going to do it to me, right? And I get it's the CIA. Now, I get, like, they hack in, the FBI, they're corrupt. Look what happened under their bureaucratic watch when they're not elected. And that's why you need to go to, a reform school. Pronto. Otherwise, Dopey Joe can swing on a rope with you. I guarantee it.
Okay, now repeat after me, right? You don't want me to post things and I'm bad because lives are at stake or something in the shadows, and you know that, but I don't, with the trafficking or whatever. And because you're so cool and the goodness of your heart, I gotta keep my trap shut for Fight Club. Well, I don't know, I'm my club. I don't think you understand who I am. I can't do that, sir or madam. I didn't pledge surety to retards. Forgive me. I mean yourself. So, you know, because that's against my religion. That's against my faith and my belief system on a church level. And I have freedom of religion, let alone freedom of press to say what the fuck I want, let alone freedom of speech, you idiot, as a separate thing. But then also on a constitutional level, I pledge allegiance to the flag in the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty, justice for all, with liberty and justice for all, actually. So I can't do that.
I mean, that's just broken you with your fucking half sound and half. First of all, it should never be allowed to pop up when you're listening to your headphones. You're not comfortable with it. Second of all, some do not serve. This is what they need to know.
Let me do a little bit of a captain's log here for you. Keep you apprised of what's going on. First of all, like, if people can't say hi, Tim, but they're snooping around the Truman Show, like, right, just don't let them run anything. Don't let them script anything. They're not. They're grown people, but they can't even say hi, but yet read between the lines. They're weird. My whole life. I get it. You did some Eliakim thing, and you said you were Christian when you're evil. I got it. I know. It's just that. Anyway. Or you just knew about Truman Show and you're some fucking scumbag American citizen, right, who, like, pledges allegiance to the triangles or something. Now, look, when it comes to sounds and haptics, I just posted a thing. I'm listening through a Bluetooth speaker, not headphones. I don't know why the headphones icon is even there, because you don't know how far away I am from the speaker. So why should you be allowed to go, bing, hey, sounds and haptics, it's too loud, lower it, when it's not headphones, first of all, it's just... I mean, especially through the actual phone when there's not Bluetooth as often, it's just the phone. You can't do that. It doesn't go that loud on the phone. That's why they have speakers. So, of course, like, sounds and haptics would know that. But yet they'll tell you just the same. Oh, no, it's set to loud volume, right? And now try me in this. It's also set to do not disturb and, like, airplane mode. I'm outside, so it's not on airplane mode. It's got 5G. And no Wi-Fi, and I turned the Bluetooth on to listen to the speaker. And that's how I set it up. And I put it on Do Not Disturb, and even though it didn't disturb me with the picture alert that says, you know, hey, turn your thing down, it still went ba-bing, ding, even though it was on silent, and it was on da-da-da-da. It still felt the need through the speaker at the time in the song that it doesn't like because it feels uncool, right? Because little children are hacking into my thing and you don't terminate their IP address, terminate their right to do that, take their Viva Vendetta mask and shove it up their ass and shoot them. Mr. Musk, not for nothing, I don't care, but some idiot just keeps... He's an idiot. He's some producer from a film, and he doesn't leave me alone, and he doesn't respect me. So I was going to actually send him a screenshot of a couple of occasions you have managed, even personally, to click like on a thing of mine. Just very recently, you wouldn't even know. You did do that. I even have the screenshot. I have it backed up locally and whatever, but then I cleaned out I have to clean the photos out of my phone. So now it's not on my phone, right? When I sent it, no one, not one person. But you would know for yourself if you click like on a couple of them or not, right? So now, if you notice, if you go to, like, my notifications, what won't pop up, as if you clicked unlike, the same as, like, Britney Spears did a couple times after just liking it, now it's gone. Never happened. But I have those screenshots backed up locally, same as yours. But I don't feel like going home to get it, da-da-da-da-da. I want to be able to take a fucking screenshot of my notifications and send it to, like, my family or, like, anyone, right? Because I could have done that. I even got the screenshot, chose not to, but saved it locally. And now I don't have access to it because on the notifications, oh, Elon never clicked like on that one or that one or that one or that one. So it's very annoying. You should fire them immediately because that's illegal. The only reason you managed to get it through was so, like, I understand it. And I didn't, like, public, but this is, that's, see, but then they do that because I don't do that. If I don't, like, make it, never happen. So you need to fire some fucking people, including that goddamn CEO, Linda Joke. Anna, I'll see to it that you get fired, you racist prick lady. I don't care you got a vagina. I wasn't very easy on Musk or Zuckerdoosh or some of the other ones that are a little nicer, but you strike me as, see, Musk wouldn't do that, but you put a battery alert and you're fired. It's pathetic. They even put a blob up. I think it's a 20% real quick, and it made the thing stop recording because you're fired. You're racist. You're a business ethics. I will sue you and just sign it because otherwise you'll wind up treason. You see, even here, even now, I'm at this Water Bagel Brooklyn place right by my house. I don't know what it could be. I don't know the name. It's not that, but it's close, right? So I didn't say the name, but I'm in the store, right? And, you know, I say to the lady, just two hash browns, a muffin, and a large coffee, please. That's it. Because she's snarky and mean to me every fucking time I walk in here, right? I understand something. So, yeah, I tip, you know, I add the tip, I do the thing, right? And pay, and she hands me a small cup. So I don't notice it right away, but I say, like, excuse me, I ordered a large coffee. Can I just switch the cup for a large cup? You don't, huh? Well, you charged me for a large. No, I have the receipt. You did. And the other employee, I have a large cup right here, sir. So it's like, you know, that's racist. And I didn't name the employee or the technically the company, but I'm in the place, right? It's a bagel place, right? Anyway. They know which, you should, if not fire that person, you should talk to them about, that's racist. Nah, I got it, young lady, but it's, the food's still on here and you just, you hate Jesus and you hate Christians because you're a Wiccan cranny and you're racist and that's illegal, treasonous.
Excuse me, well, I had ordered those hash browns a long, long time ago. I'm just wondering, they never brought them. She had asked me to ask up here. The hash browns. Are they hot?
They've been sitting.
You mind making me two fresh ones because they've been sitting for 30 minutes? Is that all right?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Captain's log, just a journal entry here, going back to my car, and of course I'm surrounded by FINN me, and there was a 666 car, seems to be replaced by Commander Riker here, okay, I mean, like, you have to understand, this is like, they do know they do that to me, and I'm not human to them, I'm just some rat in their rat race, and doggy, and they make it clear, but I'm gonna make something clear, no, that's not legal!
Here's the litmus test for you, whoever you are, right? You go up to them, first of all, they're going to sign it on a state level, but if they got a problem with this, they're probably very guilty of bossy activity, including murder and torture and exploiting wage earners and lying to children and all that. So here's how you go. If they really still at this point in time, whatever the past, can't admit it, this is what you do. Ready? You say, are you a god? And then when they say yes, you say, good. Pop, and you fucking kill them. No, the next one. Are you a god? Oh, good. Pop. How about you? Oh, you're not, huh? Okay, you can sign it then. Sign. Oh, I'm serious. They're nuts. Puny reek. But I'm a girl with a vagina. That's sexist. So what if I that was kids and I stabbed them? I do sexy stuff. You can't hurt me. Oh, you think that, huh? Pop. Any other bitch think that? Oh, you do, huh, bitch? You're a goddess? Good! Perfect! Good! Perfect! Pop! Oh, you a goddess? Perfect! Bitch, you're over the 18th, easy, you're over the... Oh, you're 22, huh? Perfect! Pop! In all seriousness, here's a real fucking litmus test. Are you a parent? Are you over the age of 18? Do you agree I have rights? What about your children? If not, drop dead!
I don't think you want to have allegiance to the coven anymore, or the high priestess, or the goddess, or the reek, or the fucking satanic wizard man. I think you're down by law, and it's treason, and we can kill you for that. You know, you try to lead the horse to water, Mr. Carey, or whoever, you know, anyone. I know about the celebrities or the hockey players or some of these people, but, like, you can lead them to water, but, like, it doesn't matter. Like, they're stuck, like, you could tell them, like, you could just sign something, maybe you wear a yarmulke, like, 10 minutes a month or something, and, like, everybody's guilty of something in this fucking country at this point in time. And then it wouldn't matter what you did. You're not first in line to have your deeds exposed. You signed it. Da 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 da. Nobody does it better. Keeping the secret safe or whatever. But that's only if you learned something and you were prepared to, like, you like that and you like your rights and you don't want to be bossed around. You know you're not boss here. The Constitution is boss. Then, well. But these people, they don't, you know, mistakes were made on both sides. Let's sign it. Oh, they don't. Oh, no, they're boss, and, like, you know, they gotta kill us. But that's not gonna work. But don't forget about the sacred right of the Sith. We get to kick the little doggy children Jedi kids around because we chased it and passed or something. And most of my scripts, we don't like him. Well, meet the Constitution, Reek.
Cheer. What a magical time of year. Howdy ho, it's Weasel Stomping Day. Put your Viking helmet on. Spread that mayonnaise on the lawn. Don't you know it's Weasel Stomping Day?
Weasel Stomping Day.
All the little girls and boys love that wonderful crunching noise.
You'll know what this day's about
when you stomp a weasel's guts right out. So come along and have a laugh. Snap their weaselly spines in half. Street, crushing weasels beneath their feet.
Why we do it, who can say?
But it's such a festive holiday, so let the stomping fun begin. Bash their weaselly skulls right in. It's tradition that makes it okay. Hey everyone, it's Weasel Stomping.
We'll have some fun on Weasel Stomping.
Put down your gun, it's Weasel Stomping Day. Hip hip hooray, it's Weasel Stomping Day.
Stomping Day.
Hey!
Psalm 23, a Psalm of David. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup runs over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Now, if I was you, I'd keep my eye on Doc. He seems pretty upset.
Cons are always upset about something. Put your overalls on.
Mr. Zimmerman, I'm making a new table. I need a hatchet.
Bob, get Doc a hatchet.
Mr. Zimmerman! Will you come over here for a minute?
Dead in your report.
All right, so I'm just leaving the usual haunt here. I see cops pulling out again. No reason. I assume they're not here for me again. I'm walking any other way to do nothing. And that's all about it.
So I have some thoughts. Are you allowed to do a comedy album where you say kind of joke but what you want and make a joke about people who hack up children should be not above the law? Can that really get you locked up? I mean, yeah, because, you know, like, really, I think it was clearly labeled as a comedy album, right? A track on a comedy album made by your own admission? And, you know, here I am saying, you know, that's like a character from track 10. You know, it doesn't supersede that I personally go out of my way to say I'm a Christian and we need peace and we like the Constitution and there's lots of, like, hacking things going on. Apple won't even give you your local hard drive space back when you, like, do-do-do-do. You know, there's Censorino people. There's all kinds of stuff. But, like, you know, should you do a joke where you're in character but it's for the album, it's overtly like the very next track, you're calm again. That doesn't represent your mental state. But, you know, if I say, these Gungans, are you a Gungan? Perfect. Pop. You know, it doesn't actually mean what you can do with it is like, no, I'm certain I'm right. But you can discuss. I mean,
Misha gonna gather my thoughts, okie day. Misha gonna get a shave and a haircut. Oh, yes. At some point today and tomorrow, I'm gonna have a dog. And Misha, we're gonna discuss. We're gonna get into it, alright, Marie? Alright.
Hey, Perman. Rudy. Rudy. Rudy, right? Or is it Rufio, right? Roof. I think it's, Riggs. You know what I mean? Hey, Perman. Rudy. Rudy. Rudy, right? Or is it Rufio, right? Roof. I think it's, Riggs. You know what I mean?
Detective? Oh, you're a detective. Oh.
That's, why I'm here.
Yeah. Meow, meow, meow.
Did you know on the movie Checkmate, the short film called Checkmate,
there is a character that is the good guy, a Perry, and then there's also a bad guy, and that one's Gaston. Did you know that if you watch that movie verbatim and understand something, you would understand that Perry is Gaston and checkmate. And Obi-Wan is Jango Fett. Oh, checkmate again. But, I mean, you know, even Ewan McGregor seems to do movies about how they, like, made clones of him or something. I don't know. I mean, that's either true or it's not. But I bet Gaston, did you know that the Gaston? And then they do the thing with the Steven Spielberg had the competition with the music and the ripoff Pirates music, right? Anyway, I mean, my buddy Alan would know what I'm talking about, but really, I don't care. It was just a joke for him. Maybe just him, though. Always two there are. And I got Jesus. And the Ghostbusters, always two there are. Father God and Lord Jesus. And I'll let you know about it, man. I wouldn't try it. All right, time for a little secret council, a little ultimate secret stuff. Let me explain basically a little analogy. Let me just explain what it is, how it works. Okay, the Sanin are trained by the Force himself, right? By Father God personally. Not even teacher, not but like personally Father God. There's three. Jeremiah, Ryan, Timmy, Sunani, and technically his name was Satan at the time, right? And it's just three that were taught, and like then from there, and yeah, it's something just like that. I get it's weird. No, Lord Jesus, he's like the fourth. I mean, that's not the.
We've got the American Gook Greek. See it on his white, pasty skin. For control computer, it's computer. You gotta have to just. Take him away, you know? Want some more jitsu, how to deal with some straight person who hates gays, right? You say, fuck you, you fucking straggit. You fucking straggit. I'm gonna call you faggot, because it's short for fucking straggit. Yeah, and just do that.
I did tell you, don't trust anyone, right?
Spielberg, sir, I don't think myself or Short Round or probably other people have trusted you in a long time. Like, not completely, you know.
Facts first. You know, when they say be safe, be safe. Right? Listen, snarky. You can either be safe or be honest. But you can't really do both these days.
Guys, come on. He's just he's a complete nut. He's not a liar king or even a Christian or even anyone worth talking. He doesn't have rights. He doesn't even deserve them as American. He's crazy. He's psychotic. He's on antipsychotics. You know, the honest doctors always try to push the antipsychotics. At least these ones didn't do that. All right. No, I'm not psychotic. You know, the honest blah, blah, you know, nothing. You're not at all the scam artist, right? Yes, and then on it goes, and then, like, you know, certain Humpty and Dumpties and parents are like, right, they just assure you, oh, yeah, because otherwise he's saying we're bad. And discuss.
I mean, the Muslims got to appreciate it a little bit over here in America. I know, like, that through America. Well, nah, don't say that, man. Wait a minute. Our slogan, I got these people old, dang it. Even yours is screwed. But like, that's because they don't listen to Allah. They don't like Allah. They don't like Allah's Quran. They don't like Allah's Bible. They hate Jesus. Even the Muslims love Jesus. See, I try to tell them. I know they believe it a little bit, but like, they don't say he didn't walk the earth. And no. It's just offensive. Of course Jesus was a guy with the miracles and the flashes who would say, may God bless you. And why you say he's good? Only God is good. Be perfect as Father in heaven is perfect. Anyway, you gotta appreciate a little like what we used to be. Our slogan was in Allah we trust. In Allah we trust? I mean, how bad could they have been? In God we trust. That's the slogan.